Good morning and welcome to Wayne Goldsboro Television. I'm Kim Best.
And I'm Wayne Alley. Hello there. It is a Thursday morning. It is June the whatever day it is, the 13th.
All day long.
All day. I lose track of that so easily. Yeah, hope you're doing well today. It's another warm day in the area. We have had, can you believe the temperatures? Of course, in the past years, June was the first month we see 100 degree temperatures.
Exactly.
And we may hit that eventually, but here in Wayne County, gee, what is it? Mid and upper 90s for the last couple of 3 days there.
So
it's interesting. Of course, we have had a tremendous amount of rain over the last week or two. And I think I heard that or read somewhere that the Neuse River here in Wayne County will be cresting Friday. And there may be some minor flooding. As I've noticed the last couple of days coming across, when I come in...
It looks like it's just getting higher and higher.
Yeah, I come in on Arrington Bridge, when I cross the Neuse, I notice it's getting on up there. It's not quite there yet, but it'll crest. And we may have some minor flooding in low-lying areas over the next day or so, so be real careful there. And again, if you happen to see a road that is blocked or barricaded, do not go around those barricades.
There's a reason.
That's right. There's a reason they're there. Only 6 inches of water rushing across the road can move your entire vehicle, so don't take any chances. Don't drown, turn around, I think they say.
And we've seen a tremendous amount of that happening right there in Raleigh near Crabtree and other places where people think they can drive through it and the water comes rushing down and it turns their car all the way around and upside down and all types of various things, and it's very dangerous.
It can be, so it just doesn't make sense. Don't take any chances. Go around, okay?
That's right.
All right, well, Kim, who is on today's program?
Well, today we have one program on that'll last most of the show.
Oh, okay.
And it is the Arts Council of Wayne County, and Miss Goldsboro Beth Stovall had a talent show, and this is part two of the talent show where you will see young children that are in elementary school and middle school performing all different types of talents, and you'll actually see the winners that are showcased. So that is all on today's show. All happened at the Arts Council.
How about that?
Yeah.
All right.
Young people doing all kinds of talents.
I love that. I love talent shows. Although I don't watch them on TV.
You don't?
I just don't.
Oh, that's right. We've talked about it. You don't watch American Idol. You don't watch any of those shows. You're not interested.
I'm just a kind of a boring guy, I guess.
Yeah, right.
That's just me, right. Today's trivia question. How about that?
That sounds good.
Take me to your leader, Earthling. You ever heard anybody say that? Take me to your leader, Earthling?
I believe I might have.
All right. Earthling is a very specific word, and it means something in particular, and it doesn't mean what it used to mean.
It doesn't mean that you're a person on Earth?
I'll let you figure it out. That's our trivia question today. What's the original meaning of the word earthling?
Okay.
Earthling.
We'll think about it.
Think about that.
Earthling.
And we'll have an answer for you later on in the program.
That sounds good, Wayne.
Take me to your leader, earthling.
Well, we want to remind you, if you're interested in attending a pool, there is a couple of pools here in town Goldsboro that you can visit on a daily basis, or you can also go and get passes to visit all summer, Wayne.
Okay.
And they are Peacock Pool.
Okay.
Which is at 1503 Herring Street here in the city.
Okay.
Or at Mina Wheel Pool, which is 235 House Street, also in the city limits. You can go on the website of the City of Goldsboro, which is goldsboronc.gov, and check out their operation hours, their fees. If you go for the day, there's one fee, but if you'd rather just go ahead and get a whole summer pass, you can do that as well and visit any of these.
Hey.
I know, it's really nice.
Okay, now I know where Mina Wheel is on, I didn't know it was House Street. I just thought it was just off John Street.
Yeah.
But where is Herring Street? Do you have any idea?
I don't know how to explain it to you. I know. So the easiest thing to do, there are details on the website, though, that give you directions and that type thing.
Of course there.
These pools are operated by the Family Y. They're owned by the City of Goldsboro, but they're operated by the Family Y.
Well, that's convenient.
And if you're a member of the Family Y, you can go to either one of these pools free of charge. You just have to show your membership badge.
How about that?
Isn't that nice?
That is nice.
Mm-hmm. Both pools have different hours of operation, so we just want to make sure you do go to the website to view that if you're interested. But they are two pools that opened back on Memorial Day, and they are open to the public. We want you to take advantage of them. And one of them is over by the city's maintenance complex.
I'll bet that's Peacock.
I bet it is, too. Just get me.
Just off Clingman Street.
Exactly.
Okay,
exactly.
There you go.
Yep.
There you go. But go on the website anyway and get the...
Yeah, goldsboronc.gov, and it'll give you all kinds of information. Go down on the left-hand side of the website to Departments, yeah. Parks and Rec, and there you'll get all your information you need.
There you go. You know, one day recently, and within the last week or two, we had a guy named Pete Ween in the studio
yes.
here, and
mm-hmm.
Pete is with the... Amateur Radio Association here in Wayne County, Wayne County Amateur Radio Association. And these guys are going to have a field day coming up on the 22nd. Now, if you're at all interested in radio, and this is, we're talking about ham radio,
oh, yes.
Communications between two individuals, there's going to be a field day coming up on June 22nd, which is not all that long away, and it's going to be
held
over at the... at the school,
Meadow Lane?
I think it's Meadow Lane, near Meadow Lane School. Anyway, mm-hmm. when you get there, Greenwood.
Oh, Greenwood Middle, okay.
Which is near there.
Yeah, they're right across the street okay. from one another.
Okay, this is going to be at Greenwood Middle School in the forested area there, mm-hmm. near the trees. 3209 East Ash Street on June 22nd and 23rd, field day there. If you want to participate, you talk to Pete Ween, you can go onto their website. Their website is k4cyp.com, k4cyp.com, get information there. But this is an enormous hobby. Anybody that knows anything at all about ham radio knows the enormity of this particular hobby. And if you've ever wanted to perhaps get into ham radio or radio, you don't have to be an operator to enjoy it. And you can certainly go over there and take part in the... Amateur Radio Association's Field Day. This is again June 22nd, 23rd, and tell them we sent you over there, okay? And just go and have a good time. It's going to be a fantastic weekend.
And if anybody wants to see the interview that you recently did with him about ham radio, explaining what ham radio is
yeah.
and more details, you can go to YouTube and find all that on the city or the county's website.
You know, that's right, because we do archive all our programs.
Yes.
And you could go to the WayneGov.com website and click on the YouTube link on the right-hand side of the page there.
That's
and
right.
it'll take you to the to YouTube, and it'll list, you'll get to recent updates, and you can find the program that way.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can go to the city site.
That's right. It's goldsboronc.gov, and you can do the same exact thing.
All right.
Well, I believe it's time to go ahead to our big showcase of the day, which is a talent show for elementary and middle school students at the Arts Council of Wayne County.
There you go.
So stay tuned.
Thank you. right on my brain. He left his dead like a man insane. He broke my wings, I bought a freight. And then they wrecked his dreaded balls of fire.
Oh! All right, so we're going to move on to our next phase of competition here tonight. Writing is the next category, and our first participant is Jasmine Brown. Jasmine Brown attends Rosewood Middle School, where she is in seventh grade. Her hobbies include singing, writing poetry, photography, and cooking. Jasmine is unable to join us tonight, but her writing will still be good. And at this time, since even though she's not here, I would still like for you to hear what she wrote, so I'm going to read for you what she wrote.
So this is by Jasmine Brown, and it's called Passion. What is passion? To understand it, first you have to ask yourself that question. Let me explain to you my answer to that question and my reasoning. Passion. Passion for some people gets them out of bed in the morning. Passion is what makes us want to live, makes us strive to do better. When you see a person down on their luck, and they look like they just don't care. Maybe they don't have a passion or haven't found their passion yet. Some people go a lifetime without finding their passion. Personally, I can't even imagine living without a passion. I feel like I'm blessed. I have two passions, music and cooking. I can't live without music. I can't even see my future without music being a big part of my life. Then there's cooking. I love to bake and I love to cook. I don't know what I would do without them both in my life. I could name a couple of people who feel the same way about their passions. For instance, my friends Rebecca, Mackenzie, and Brittany. They love to dance. I know that it would be hard for them to never dance again. Horseback riding for Elena. She loves it. I don't even have to ask her. If you told Katrina that she could never do gymnastics ever again, she would just freak out. Because that's just what you do when you find your passion and someone just takes it away from you. Passion leads to your future. My father told me once, don't get a job you hate and not go to work every day. Get a job you love and be excited every day to go to work. It's true, because why wouldn't you be excited about doing the thing that you love every day? Passion sets your hopes and dreams before your eyes, before you even wanted them. One day you might say, I want to be this. Then the next day you find something else you love, and slowly as the days go on, you realize what you really want to be, and you think it is, and you think is what, and you think this is what I was meant to be all along. For instance, I love to sing. I want to learn how to play piano and guitar. I just love music. Before I thought I wanted to be a chef with my own restaurant. Now I realize I want to be a middle and high school chorus teacher so I can share my passion with others and help them grow. Then maybe later in life, co-own a restaurant with a friend. What I don't like is when people tell me, you're young, you change what you want to be all the time, but they don't listen. When you find a passion so strong like mine, age doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is the heart. I know in my heart I want to be a chorus teacher and nobody's going to change that. Sometimes people are pushed into their passions, and that's great, but I would never do that to a person. A person deserves a passion they truly love in their heart, and personally, I think that can only be achieved when a person finds their own passion, because a passion is like a flower. Cliche, I know, but true in so many ways. It's beautiful, delicate, and when you find it, you never want to give it up. When you think of a rose, you think of love. You think of love. Same with passion. But just like a flower, a passion can die. I say there are two ways. One, it wasn't a real passion. It was just something you liked a lot. Two, you leave the earth and it goes too. But sometimes that doesn't happen. Sometimes you keep it. But just like a dandelion, it can be reborn again by the seeds that keep it alive. I have a passion. I hope you have one too, but if you don't, I hope you find one before it's too late. That's my answer and my reasoning. What's yours? But the question will never be truly answered because all people see it differently. So the question will always remain, what is passion? Thank you. And the next participant in our riding category is Juana Ortiz. And you can come on up, Juana, because she is here and she is going to read her poem for you. Juana is 14 years old. She's in the eighth grade at Brogdon Middle. She's a member of Alpha Kappa Alpha Beta Club band, Sisters with Vision. She was in Battle of the Books. She's a member of the soccer team, and she also participates in many essay contests. She has perfect attendance. She's an AB Honor Roll and Principal's List student, and her hobbies include singing and playing music, playing soccer, reading, and especially writing. So I'm going to let you go ahead and read your poem for us.
Thank you. As you said, my name is Juana Ortiz, and today I'll be reading a poem. It's called Have You Ever Stopped to Notice? Have you ever stopped to notice how beautiful our trees around us? How many wonderful things they give us? They give us shade to run under, they give us fresh air to breathe, and so many other wonderful things. Have you ever stopped to notice how painful it is to a tree when we cut it down? How ugly it is to see our trees destroyed? Have you ever stopped to notice? All right, thank you, Juana.
So the reason that I'm so passionate about inspiring others to become involved in the arts is partly because of my journey and my experiences with art. It's because I joined choir, or chorus rather, in eighth grade that I discovered this is what I'm going to do with my life. I'm always going to sing. I knew from that moment on, even though I had always loved to sing, I realized that that's what I was going to do for the rest of my life. I knew I was going to go into music, I was going to go to college for music. Taking that class is what put me here today. So I'm now leaving to Wilmington and I'm being classically trained. And with that said, I'm going to sing for you Quando Mimbo from the opera La Boheme by Puccini. And this is what I'll be singing in this year's Miss North Carolina pageant on June 22nd. So I hope you enjoy it. Olivia Haverty is our first participant, and can come ahead and come up if you want. Olivia Havery is 10 years old. She is in fourth grade at the Havery Christian Academy. She's a member of the Stepping Stone Staples Horse Show Team, the Bridge Church of Mind Team, and she's a cancer survivor, which is amazing, and I think we should give her a round of applause.
I will
born. I really appreciate it. This is my passion, and it is so, so inspiring to see you guys come out, perform, and just show your talents and perform and be very confident in yourself. This is what I live for, and thank you so much. I really appreciate it. So before we present awards, I want to give our judges some time to, you know, tabulate the scores and whatnot. So I wanted to talk to you a little bit about my preparation for Miss North Carolina. So I'm Miss Goldsboro, 2013, and what this means is on June 22nd, I'll be competing for the crown for Miss North Carolina. And for those of you who don't know a lot about the Miss America organization, it's not just about putting on a pretty dress and walking on stage for 2 seconds. There's so much more that goes into it. You have to be a well-rounded woman from head to toe. You have to be updated on current events. You have to have a personal platform, which for me is inspiration art. You have to be passionate about that platform. You have to do things that show that you're committed to that platform. And you also have to be committed to Children's Miracle Network, which for those of you who don't know, is nationally partnered with the Miss America organization, and they work towards funding for Children's Miracle Network hospitals. So these funds go to the hospitals and they help out thousands of kids, not just in North Carolina, but across the country, and that's pretty amazing. So you have to be updated on everything, you know, from your personal platform to Children's Miracle Network hospitals. You have to be updated on your current events. You have to be talented, which any of you young ladies definitely have that in the bag. So if you're interested in being in the Miss America organization, you've already got one thing down for sure. So you have to be talented, then you have to be confident in who you are so that you can speak in front of large groups of people confidently and calmly, and you have to be able to present yourself well. There's just a lot more that goes into it than just being pretty and putting on makeup and getting on stage for 2 seconds. The skills that you learn in preparation for this, you take with you for the rest of your life. It's definitely more than just a one-night thing. And even if I don't win in June, I've still learned so much and gained so much from this experience. And being Miss Goldsboro has really given me the opportunity to reach out to the kids in the community, not just the kids, visiting the schools and speaking to the kids, but also the parents as well, and just people in general. I've had wonderful opportunities that I might not have had if I weren't Miss Goldsboro. And I'm really, really honored and blessed to represent this great community that I was born and raised in. So those are just some of the things that I kind of wanted to talk to you about in relation to Miss North Carolina and being Miss Goldsboro. I have tried to inspire everyone that I've come in contact with, and in return, I've been inspired and I've been touched by everyone that I've met along this journey. So before we present the awards, are we ready yet? I just want to once again thank you all. I know I've thanked you a million times, but I really can't express to you how important it is that you get your children involved in this, and it helps them discover their talents. Thank you to everyone who has helped make this night happen. My parents, my dad made the program tonight, and he's, I think, done a really good job working this down and figured it out before the contestants, and that's the important thing, right? Thank you to all of my family who have come out and helped set up and have helped me get all these goodie bags together. Thanks to Bake My Day, because they have given you some treats, the contestants some treats, and the judges some treats and gift certificates. Thank you to the Arts Council who provided this building for us, and they're such a wonderful, wonderful building, and the people who work here are amazing. Letitia and Aaron, Letitia, who sang the national anthem, is hilarious, number one, and talented, and she's just a great person. And she's got a yes, I love you.
Oh, yes.
But yeah, so if any of you didn't know about this place, you should definitely check it out. There's all kinds of things you can do. There's classes that you can take over the summer. There's an upstairs where you can take like guitar lessons, and they have a summer program. And of course, you can always come at any time and just look at all of these paintings, and there's another room over here where people from around the community have, you know, who are into pottery, have sculpted things, and there's like necklaces and jewelry and clothes in there that just people from around the community who are really creative have brought here so that everyone can see. So in case you didn't know, this is a really cool spot, so you should check it out. Alright, are we about ready? Okay, yay! So once again, let me just say congratulations to everybody, as I said, for having the courage to come up and participate. And I'm telling you, we had a difficult job. These scores are very close. In fact, in one instance, there was only 1 point separating first and second place. So everybody did a fantastic job. Thank you both for letting us be part of it.
Thank you, guys.
All right, so are you ready? You guys can't be ready. All right, so I'm going to start out in the art category. And our second place winner is, well, before I say that, I know I just killed you. Can I ask all of the contestants to come up here and say that?
And we're back on Wayne Goldsboro Television.
Yes, we are. Hi.
Did you enjoy all the little talent?
That was so much fun. That was great. I love that.
I do too.
It was so cute.
I know.
Yeah.
But it's pretty cool to find out more and more kids have talent right here in our community.
We do have an extraordinarily talented area.
We do.
And I don't say that because I live here. I say that because it's true. We have so much talent here.
We do. And we're lucky that we have so many different outlets that you can showcase them.
Oh, now that's true.
Because we really do.
It doesn't matter how much good talent you have. If you don't have somewhere to show it off, what good is it?
That means you have to leave, and we don't want you to have to do that. If you want to go showcase it somewhere else.
That's right. You stay put.
Stay right
where you are. Let's take a quick look at today's birthdays. Two names who have been in show business ever since they were little bitty babies. Mary Kate,
that little
little bitty babies, Mary Kate and Ashley Olson.
Oh yeah, today's their birthday.
Today is their birthday, June 13th. They are 26 years old.
Wow,
those little bitty babies are 26. I remember, I can see them like it was yesterday. They're standing up in their little cribs on whatever that show was.
What was the name of that show?
Something, yeah. Tim Allen. And I can picture him, little bitty Tim Allen, standing up in his crib. No, wait a minute. That's something else.
I don't think that was Tim Allen.
No. Home Improvement's Tim Allen, and of course the voice of Buzz Lightyear in the movie. Toy Story. Yes. But Tim Allen's having a birthday. He's 59 years today. Ally Sheedy, the actress, celebrating. She is 50 today. John Boy is having a birthday today. Richard Thomas.
John Boy.
John Boy of John Boy. Good night, John Boy. Good night, Elizabeth. Good night.
The Waltons.
The Waltons, yeah.
How old is he?
Richard Thomas turned 61 today.
Really?
He does. Well.
It happens.
It happens. Eventually.
It does happen.
Eventually.
Yes.
You reach it. And Siegfried Fischbacher is having a birthday today. Don't try that at home.
No, don't.
Siegfried Fischbacher is having a birthday. Goodness. He's 73. Siegfried and Roy.
Yes.
The magicians.
Yes.
And animal trainers. All right, having a birthday today.
Well, happy birthday to all of them and to you if it is your birthday.
Yeah.
In birthday land.
Out in birthday land.
Yes, in birthday land. And we want you to remember and put on your calendar June 20th, which is right around the corner.
That's right.
We're having movie night at the Paramount Theater.
We are.
And it's a John Wayne movie.
Oh, boy.
And I know you love John Wayne movies.
Well, I do, Pilgrim.
I knew you were going to do that.
She knew I was going
to. The name of the movie is The Horse Soldier.
Oh, that's a good one.
The Horse Soldier.
That's a good
Tickets are $5. If you want to purchase tickets, you can stop by the Paramount. You can call them at 919-583-8432 or go to GoldsboroParamount.com and purchase the tickets. $5. You can see the John Wayne classic on a very large screen at the Paramount Theater. They do those 4 or 5 times a year.
Right.
Tell us a little bit about that particular movie. I'm sure you know about it.
It's based on a historical event from back in the late 1800s,
mm-hmm.
Grierson's Raid, I believe it was. It's Grierson's Raid and the Battle of Newton Station,
yes.
Led by Colonel Benjamin Grierson. And that will be taking place at the Paramount.
Right.
And what was the date on that?
June 20th, 7 o'clock p.m.
June 20th. The day before summer officially begins.
How about that?
How about that?
That's the perfect thing to do, the day before summer officially begins.
Celebrate the passing of spring.
Yes, by watching The Horse
John
Soldier.
Wayne movie, The Horse Soldier.
That's right.
Yeah, that's a great movie. If you like John Wayne, and I do, then that's a good movie.
Well,
that's
I think it's a good idea that the Paramount's doing that.
Oh,
you know, 4 or 5 times a year they'll show totally different kinds of movies, and they have some little refreshments in there. This is the one time a year they'll allow you to take refreshments into the Paramount Theater.
Wow.
Woohoo! That's right.
Now, that's great.
So mark your calendars.
Did I ever give you my impression of John Wayne?
Well, why don't you give it to me now?
Well, he was tall and kind of rugged looking and a pretty good actor. That's my impression
of John
Wayne.
That's your impression?
Yeah.
Is that the only impression we get?
Well, yeah.
Okay.
That's
here's
all the answer to today's trivia question. Oh, and by the way, today, the 13th, is Career Nurse Assistance Day, and it's also the Queen's official birthday. Although they celebrate at a different time,
it's
the Queen's official birthday. And today's trivia question answer?
Yes.
The answer to today's trivia question?
Earthling. What does it mean?
The original meaning of the word earthling has been around a long time.
Back when people came from Mars, right?
Exactly, but no, not really. This is it's an old English word meaning farmer.
Really?
Earthling. What do you do?
Well, I'm an earthling. Yep. Yep.
Okay, there you go.
There you go.
I don't believe that's what the Martians, how they called it.
That's right, yeah.
Well, I believe we're wrapping it up for today.
Are we ready to wrap?
I believe we are. It's time to go.
Already time to go. So we'll do this again tomorrow. So join us then tomorrow as our program runs at 7 a.m. and we repeat at noon, 5:30, and then again at either 7 or 8 p.m. at night, depending on the night. And then again, of course, on weekends. So join us at those times, and we will be back Friday. We'll be back one day
tomorrow.
This week.
We have a good lineup, so stay tuned.
Watch
tomorrow.
I've got to read my calendar again. I forget which day is which. But anyway, we'll be back tomorrow, so join us tomorrow. Until then, I'm Wayne Alley.
And I'm Kim Best, and this is what's happening in your community.